Dive deep into timeless tales. Join our Bible's literature series where ancient stories come alive. Discover the Bible like never before as captivating narratives, not just sacred texts. Your literary adventure awaits. Dive into the Bible with us, a tapestry of tales and truth, where the sacred texts shape community conversations.
Paul's encounter with Rome, a tale of faith and resistance. When examining the life of the Apostle Paul in the book of Acts, the author had to consider how Paul and his fellow Christians would be perceived by Roman readers. The central question was whether their beliefs and practices aligned with accepted norms of Roman society or if they posed a subversive threat to the established order. This lecture explores three aspects of Paul's character and actions as described in Acts. His message concerning Jesus' kingship in relation to the emperor, the interaction of Paul's message with other religious traditions in the Roman Empire, and the accounts of Paul's imprisonment and trials. Jesus' kingship. The story of Paul begins in Acts chapter 17, where he travels to the city of Thessalonica after leaving Philippi. The narrative follows a pattern in which Paul initially engages with local Jewish communities by visiting synagogues and presenting Jesus as the promised Messiah in Jewish scriptures. According to Acts, some individuals, including Greek men and prominent women, embraced Paul's message. However, trouble arises when members of the synagogue become alarmed by Paul's increasing influence and seek assistance from ruffians who vandalize the house where Paul and Silas are staying. These individuals accuse Paul and Silas of turning the world upside down by claiming the existence of another ruler, Jesus, alongside the emperor. The author of Acts raises an ironic question: who truly possesses a threat to the social order? Paul and his followers, who are peacefully advocating their beliefs, or those who disrupt the peace and attack innocent people while claiming to be pro-Roman? The writer acknowledges the subversive aspect of Paul's message as it challenges the ultimate loyalty to the emperor and implies a higher allegiance to Jesus. 1 Thessalonians. The letter known as 1 Thessalonians, believed to have been written around 50 AD, serves as Paul's oldest surviving letter. It was composed to encourage the congregation in Thessalonica after Paul had moved on to Athens and possibly Corinth. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 9, Paul mentions how the Thessalonians turned away from idol worship to serve the living and true God. This suggests that the Thessalonian Christians had previously worshipped the gods of Greece and Rome. Paul addresses the challenges they faced upon transitioning from their former worship practices to accepting the message of Jesus. His response affirms many conventional values, emphasizing integrity, hard work, respect for family life, and decent behavior towards others. However, in chapter 5, Paul introduces a more subversive element by emphasizing the theme of hope. He envisions a future resurrection and challenges the notion of permanent peace and security in the current order, instead depicting the followers of Jesus as warriors equipped with faith, love, and hope. Paul's message in other religious traditions. In the later part of Acts chapter 17, Paul finds himself in Athens, a center of Greek culture and philosophy. Philosophers such as Stoics and Epicureans were prominent in this intellectual hub. The Stoics referred to a divine energy using terms like God and Logos, while the Epicureans believed that gods did not interfere with human life and emphasize human philosophical pursuit. Acts chapter 17 portrays a scene where philosophers engage in debate with Paul, leaving bystanders perplexed by his message. To address the confusion, Paul delivers a speech at the Areopagus. Paul's speech begins by establishing common ground, acknowledging the Athenians' strong religious inclination. He redirects this impulse towards the true God as he understands him. Paul builds his case by appealing to the idea that God created all things, emphasizing the common origin of all nations and humanity's inherent search for God. Instead of quoting from Jewish scriptures, Paul quotes the Greek poet Aratus to highlight the universal human quest for God. He concludes that true fulfillment comes not from statues of gods created by humans, but through knowledge of the God who created them, revealed through the resurrection of Jesus. Paul's imprisonment. In the final section of the narrative, both Greek and Jewish communities perceive Paul as a threat to society. The Romans intervene to maintain order and provide a fair hearing for Paul. Acts chapter 19 presents the challenges posed by the Greek community in Ephesus, where Paul encounters opposition from craftsmen who fear the impact of his teachings on their income. They accuse Paul of subversion and stage a public protest in support of the goddess Artemis. However, the town clerk acts as the voice of reason, emphasizing that Paul and his companions have not committed any crimes against the temple or blasphemed the goddess. He urges the protesters to follow legal procedures if they have legitimate grievances, highlighting the importance of fair treatment under the rule of law. Later, in a Jewish context, rumors spread that Paul is encouraging Jews to abandon their traditions and join the Christian community. To counter this perception, Paul is asked to demonstrate his obedience to Jewish law publicly. He agrees and undergoes a ritual of purification that takes him to the temple. Tensions escalate when members of the Jewish community accuse Paul of bringing non-Jews into the forbidden areas of the temple, leading to violence. In both instances, the writer of Acts portrays Paul as not posing a direct threat to the social order. Instead, it is those who oppose him and disrupt the peace that endanger the established order. The author emphasizes fair treatment and adherence to legal processes and dealing with conflicts between religious traditions. Overall, the accounts of Paul's interactions with the Roman Empire and Acts showcase the complex dynamics between his message, the Roman society, and other religious traditions. The writer explores the subversive aspects of Paul's teachings, the search for common ground, and the challenges and trials he faces as he spreads the Christian message within the Roman context.
Stay enthralled with epic sagas and ageless wisdom. Continue with us in our Bible as Literature series. Unearth stories and symbols in a fresh literary light. The next chapter of your riveting journey is just around the corner. Thank you for joining us today on this fascinating journey through the life of the Apostle Paul, as described in Acts. We've explored how Paul's teachings and actions intersected with the Roman Empire and the profound impact of his faith in challenging times. If you found today's exploration of Paul's encounters in Rome intriguing, don't miss our next episode, Finding Common Ground, Paul's Epistle Addressing Community Conflict. We'll delve into Paul's letter to the Corinthians, unraveling how he addressed crucial issues such as the unity in Christ, the role of the Spirit, and the vital importance of reconciliation within the Christian community. So make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated. Our journey through Paul's epistles promises to be enlightening, offering valuable insights into handling conflicts and maintaining unity in our own communities. Again, thank you for being with us, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Let's continue to learn and grow together in understanding the rich history and teachings of early Christianity. See you soon.